from the Westwood Complex here in Washington Township, New Jersey. WCTV is very proud to present the semifinal playoff game between High Point and Westwood. Hello, everybody. I'm Larry LaFury, along with John Frank Hall, who are on the field as both teams warm up for this important game. High Point, Westwood. John, the winner here moves on. 2 weeks from tonight, we start the championships either at MetLife Stadium or Kane University.
And I predict that game is going to be against Mahwah. And I think they're up 7-0. Expect Mahwah to be there, and one of these two teams want to play Mahwah.
It's interesting that this is a 4-seed Westwood hosting the 8-seed High Point. A 1-3 had to lose last week for Westwood to host the game here. Let's talk a little about High Point. We had a nice talk with their coach, Jim Delaney, their athletic director, Mr. Van Horn. It's a team that runs, runs, and runs. They smash mouth football.
You're absolutely correct. That's what they're going to, if they win the trenches, they're going to win the war. This team can run. They have three outstanding running backs. The one young man everybody should watch is number 31, Musili. This young man has about 1,300 yards. He will run the ball. They have outstanding linemen up front. The quarterback is a sophomore, Lashinsky. He only has 190-some yards for the whole year, and he had 143 against Pompton Lakes. Against Pompton Lakes, this team had four sacks, so the linemen are fast, are strong, and you got to block them.
Now, Westwood's going to have to stop this vaunted running attack. The coach told us we're going to run. There's no secret that we're going to run. Westwood's defense been coming up big over the last 3-4 weeks. Going to have to come up big and stop the run. But on offense, Westwood is all around Sean Hopkins, the outstanding quarterback, the dual threat. He could run, he could pass, and he's got some outstanding wide receivers in McKay and Rosenfeld. And also one who I like is Joe Kramer.
Well, those two individuals tonight are going to get the ball. They're going to throw the ball to those two big guys, 6'5 and 6'3. Should be open against a smaller team. But Hopkins, Larry, what a season he's had. He's throwing for 63% of his passes, only 6 interceptions. Plus he's got, 21 touchdowns? I mean, what a ball player. And the young man is only a junior. He's getting better and better every game.
And also, if they want to come up or they want to stop the pass, we have an outstanding running back in Cole Lukaszczyk, who, if he gets a step, he's gone. A speedy running back.
He's had 2 touchdowns. A kickoff return, Lukaszczyk, lightning, the young man can run. Watch number 33. And in the line, Larry, I'm getting so excited. I'm ready to go out there and coach.
You were like this about 3 hours ago.
My blood pressure went up to 80-something in my heart rate. This game, I would love to coach this game. Westwood's going to have 8-9 men in the box, and they're going to try to stop the run. And, of course, the young men from High Point Wildcats, they want to stop the pass, and they want to hold and make Hopkins one way. Either let him run all day or pass all day.
It's, if you like, talk about fights being a setup of styles. This is a running team, High Point. Westwood likes to pass the ball. They're passing. It'll be a great game. It's the semifinals. These two teams started in January in the weight room. They got to the last game here for the semifinal. It's one more step to go before they can get to the finals in 2 weeks. It's a great game, and WCTV will bring it to you shortly.
Thank you. field your 2016 Westwood Cardinals football team, led by head coach Dennis Hart and assistants Bobby Guy, Chris Izzo, Tom Amelia, Paul Castellini, Vinny Aiello, Mike Colucci, Matt Penn, and Jeremy Taylor.
Well, we're ready for the semifinal game to begin here on the campus of Westwood High School. High Point will kick off. Grayson Sabo will kick. Westwood will receive. Here we go, and the semifinal game is underway. And the kick is coming down to
Lukasik.
And Lukasik gets up to the 29-yard line where the Cardinals of Westwood will take over first and 10. Across the line, Trey Poutanis, Brendan Sullivan, Eric Zeltner, Brandon Brown, and Dylan Henry will be the offensive line. The quarterback will be Sean Hopkins.
So you have 20
receivers will be Jordan Rosenfeld, Sean McKay, and we'll see if they have Kramer in. Kramer is in. That's Westwood starting offense. Hopkins back, throws, has Kramer. Kramer gets across the 40-yard line for a first down and a pickup for about 11 yards. Defensively for High Point, Udemarks, Rutter, and Brunell. Off across the front, the linebackers, they play a 4-3. Huxicker, McCarrick, and Lisinski. I'll give you the defensive backs in just a moment and we'll have this all set for you. Hopkins looks, throws out again to Kramer. Kramer gets across the 50-yard, to the 50-yard line.
9 yards.
Pick up
8 yards. Eight yards, Larry.
Defensively, four High Point. Turo, Duma, Musili, and Gilmore will be defensive backs. They will interchange. Second down and 3 yards to go for Westwood. Just to start things right on the 50-yard line. It is a big crowd, and it's still filling up here.
Larry, here you have nine in the box. Nine players inside the 5-yard line.
Hopkins back, looks, wants to throw again. Throws downfield for
McKay.
Got
a man deep.
Us off the fingertips of Sean McKay.
A little bit outside that time. Well, they were talking about having 1 and 8, the two receivers going out against the smaller Warriors. Looks like number 20, well, we got those whites. We got 23. Number 23 is Matt Duma, D-O-U-M-A.
Third down now. The Tuskies in the backfield along with Hopkins, who will get the snap. Trips to the right. Hopkins will run behind Metusky. He has enough for a first down. He's in the secondary. Crosses the 40-yard line to the 36-yard line. Another first down for West.
12 yards by Hopkins that time. And he does it the way nobody else has done it at the school. He can run the ball, he waits for his blocking, and he gets a first down. What a play, this young man.
Went behind Watuski's block.
He's a good one right there, number 7.
Pitch out here to Kramer. Kramer is stopped after a short game and pushed back when he got to about the 35-yard line. Bring up 2nd and 7 for the Cardinals of Westwood.
Number 36 on the stop that time, Larry.
Tackled by Hunsicker.
And Ryan McCarrick on defense. And 31. which would be Musili. Now, he's the stud on this team. This young man has 1,299 yards from the halfback position, and he can play. He had 11 tackles against Pompton Lakes.
Hopkins calling signals. Looks. Has time. The ball is batted up in the air. Let's see. They're going to call it incomplete pass.
Looks like the hand went forward, but they called it incomplete.
Good pressure by
Erdemark, number 60, had the knock on that. Steve Erdemark, he had 2 sacks against Pompton Lakes last week.
They do bring pressure, High Point.
Oh, they were very physical. They got that good air out there, you know, in High Point.
They're growing big,
up high, you know, the oxygen. They are big, but they are strong.
Run. Has some room, gets to the outside, looking, gets to the 30-yard line.
To the 29.
Fourth and short, John. Here's a big play in the game. Now, we're going to be saying this probably a few more times. This is a big play, but this is going to be a big play.
And that was Ryan McCarrick that time, and he got to go here, fourth and two. McCarrick, 2 straight tackles.
Big defense. Now, watch Hopkins. He likes to run in these situations.
He has the option. Pass. He got trips to the right.
There he goes.
Oh, plenty of room.
He's got a first down. He's got more. Cuts back outside and gets across the 15-yard line.
15 yards on a carry. That was student right. Student class right.
That's the second time Hopkins ran behind Letuski.
Letuski does a great job. And what Hopkins does, which better than anybody else, he waits for his blockers. And that's what, if you're watching this game, this is what you have to do as a runner.
McKay and Kramer out to the left. Visage is out to the right.
From the 14-yard line.
Hopkins looks, fires downfield for McKay on an out pattern. He ran the flag pattern.
Had a nice form, a little bit overthrown.
The far left corner of the end zone. Incomplete.
The old day, we used to call that when I was younger, middle to the flats. You go to the middle and then cut to the outside. And Hopkins put it out there, only he could catch it.
You know, McKay's got 44 for 738 yards and 11 touchdowns. And his sidekick, 31 for 451 and 6 touchdowns, the 2 receivers.
They are prolific.
Oh, unbelievable.
Visage is out to the right, trips to the left. Hopkins calling signals. Hopkins going to run, and he's tripped up.
Stopped inside. Let's see. I got 59 in the area. 59 is Cliff Rutter.
Hopkins for a 1-yard gain.
Cliff Rutter was there, and I think 36 again. McCarrick.
So third down and 7 now.
And, of course, you got TJ, the toe, Constantine, just sort of getting ready, just in case he has to kick a field goal.
Ball is on the 10-yard line. Just outside the 10. Hopkins back, has room, throws inside to McKay. McKay slips one, and he gets inside the 5-yard line.
Close to a first down.
Let's see where the spot's going to be. First down, looks like, yes.
So now first and goal from the, I say, 3-yard line.
First goal for the Cardinals. They took the opening kickoff. They're marching. They got the ball on about the 33-yard line. Hopkins calling signals. Pogge's in motion to the
right. You notice it's Hopkins.
There goes Hopkins. He goes to the goal line. He's going to be a yard short. Second and goal from the 1.
I like that play, Larry. He waits to see who blocks, and depending on where the block is, he goes inside, outside.
But eye formation, first time. And Hopkins goes to the goal line. No signal yet. No signal. Now
there's
a signal.
1-yard touchdown.
So Westwood takes the opening kickoff and marches some 67 yards and scores a touchdown and goes up in the semifinal game, 6-0 over the Wildcats of High Point. Constantine will try the PAT with Hopkins holding. John, that was basically Hopkins all the way.
Oh,
he's throwing and the running.
Great move, a yard, a touchdown.
Kick is up. and it is good. So Constantine bangs it through with 7 minutes, 26 seconds to go. Westwood takes a 7-0 lead over High Point. You are watching WCTV, your volunteer cable access group from the Township of Washington, bringing you the semifinal game.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Washington Township.
Well, let's watch the replay. As you can see, the big push by the front line, and Hopkins goes in for a score. And that's, let's find Hopkins, that was his 10th touchdown rushing, Hopkins.
He puts so much pressure on a defense because he runs very well. And that up front blocking, and then you have a fullback like Matuski leading him in the hole. I wish the Giants had a fullback leading somebody into the hole.
Yeah. He reminds me of Gallagher.
Oh, yeah?
Gallagher was the one, when he was 44, the number was, at Westwood. But Rakuski last year was injured most of the year. And he's a key piece on this 8-2 Westwood team.
Constantine will kick Gilmore, captain of this team. One of the co-captains is deep. He's sitting on about the 5-yard line, waiting for the kick. Line drive kick. Come to the up back here. See who had that. Whoever had it got bombed.
We got a scrum right there. Let me see. Clear out so I can see them. Number 36, McCarrick. Ryan McCarrick.
And we called his name a couple of times. So. Couple the Wildcats will take over, first and 10.
A couple of tackles he had already today.
Eric Free is the center. Udemarks and Labar are the guards. Rudder and Rats are your tackles.
I bet Masili gets the ball.
You think so?
Yes. There it is, 31. No!
Right up the middle with Phillip, it looked like. Picked up a couple of yards. The quarterback is Jake Musinski, number 9. Chad Masili's 31. Number 7 is Jake Phillip. 25 is Rob Turo.
So Leshinsky took the ball in his first run. So they pulled a little Sean Hopkins style. Let the quarterback run.
We'll try for it.
Leshinsky, there's two of them here, you know. Larry, number 9, and of course.
Yeah, the two.
I'm trying to.
24.
Jake, yeah.
Leshinsky's calling signals. One back is Masili. Hands to Masili. And Masili gets to about the 45-yard line. Going to bring up a third down and about 3. Let's call it 4.
Stop. I think it was 76. 76 for Westwood.
Third down and 3.
Brendan Sullivan, I believe, made the tackle. So how about this? A big play right here in the first quarter. 3rd and 3. A long 3. Nice line action right here with that shot.
Phillip is in motion. Masili hits the left side. He's going to be short about a yard, maybe 2.
Now, do you, in this case, coach, do you run and go for it?
I kick.
I would too. 46 yards, we got to kick. Let's see if the head coach will send a play in to kick. Or go for the first. Yeah, there's a punt.
Sabo's going.
It's early in the game.
You can't get Westwood the ball on your side of the field. Look at those shoes he's got on him, John.
Oh, nice shoes.
Sabo, he's a sophomore.
He kicks, punts, field goals. I was watching. He kicked the ball far. They're coming.
Come back.
Ooh, a little dribbler.
Line drive, kick.
These are the ones you got to catch.
McKay lets the ball roll inside the 15-yard line. Rolling toward the 10, where it'll be down at the 11-yard line, where the Cardinals of Westwood, with 5 minutes and 10 seconds left to go in the quarter, will take over, leading 7-0.
50-yard punt and roll that time.
Not too bad, huh?
That's a great offensive move. Put them deep, and then stop them, and then you get the ball back and score.
The ball is being spotted on the 12-yard line of the Cardinals. Here's our coach. What a nice gentleman this is, Jim Delaney, Coach Delaney. Just gave us everything we needed, asked if we need anything more, and he was a very nice discussion
minutes.
On the field.
After I sent the email, 15 minutes later, I got the starting lineups.
We want to thank him and everyone up at High Point for being so helpful for us getting this game on.
Todd Van Orden.
Here's his out to Rosenfeld. He's got some room. Side steps one.
Got to have a block.
To the 30-yard line. Still on his feet. Gets across the 30 to the 33-yard line.
22-yard pass play by Rosenfeld. And Rosenfeld, that's his 25th catch. He has four TDs and four INTs.
So
he keeps, INTs and touchdown, the same number, four and four.
Not bad.
No, very nice. Got eyes of blue.
Hopkins calling signals. He wants to run off the left side. There's a room there, and it's closed quickly by Gilmore.
Great job. And Udermark. Udermark was also there, number 60. Now, Udermark against Pompton Lakes had two big sacks in that game. I tell you, they really took Pompton Lakes and put them away. 21-6 at Pompton Lakes. They're number one.
This is a very good team. They play threes
team.
And fours out there in High Point. And
very
they're a young
physical.
Team. Very young team.
And very physical.
He goes Lukashik. And Lukashik falls his way over the 40 to the 43
short, half a yard short. Oh, let me see if I'm right.
Yeah. No.
No, I'm wrong. Well, you know what it is. The referee said, hey, it's close. Give him the first down.
So Westwood,
that's lightning, Lukashik.
This drive started on the 12th.
So they got to go 88 yards.
8 yard carry for Lukashik.
And a cup of coffee at the end.
Inside 4 minutes of the fourth quarter. If you join us, Westwood marched from 67 yards for the touchdown, and they are driving again. Hopkins calling signals. Hopkins looks. Has time. Fires downfield for Kramer.
Oh, look at that.
And Kramer. Oh, the ball
goes
up there and a flag.
Yeah, that's definitely pass interference. Pass interference, 15 yards from the line of scrimmage.
And Uncle Matt agrees with it.
Uncle Matt gave a sign. He almost made a fantastic catch, Kramer.
Interference against John, when you stay next to Kramer, and I've said this every game here, you stay next to this young man. He's 6'3". He's about 205 pounds. He is unbelievable. 6'5". I lost 2 inches on him. He's 6'5". He's
205.
About 205. It's tough for these defensive backs to handle.
But if you're a defensive backer, that was Kramer there.
Yeah.
We were talking about McKay and Kramer. But that's what you're doing if you get beat. It's only 15 yards, and you can live another day.
And McKay is 6'3".
Yeah, they're
so
nice.
6'5", 6'3". This is formidable.
And I don't think anybody's over 6'1".
And then you have Lukashik running on the right side. And he has enough for just about a first down. We'll see where the spot is.
Stop by number 23, Duma. Matt Duma on the stop.
Very short. On the 33-yard line.
This is becoming a nice pattern. Pass, run.
It's a very formidable offense here. They're percolating on all those eight cylinders. Maybe nine cylinders now.
Oh, it's beautiful. It's poetry in motion right now. I haven't said that all year. I think this is time for... No.
Hopkins looks, fires downfield. Has his man. McKay, touchdown. Whoa, he
touchdown.
Made it look easy on a fly pattern. Sean McKay down the right sideline. And Westwood marches 88 yards, and they score another touchdown and go up 13-0 over High Point. Woo!
McKay did a beautiful job extending his arm, making the catch, and keeping motion. And it was a beautiful throw by Sean Hopkins.
Well, that ball was on the money. Constantine will kick. Kick is up. And it is through. So, marching 88 yards. Westwood now has a 14-0 lead with 2 minutes, 53 seconds to go in the first quarter.
And Larry, that's the 22nd pass, touchdown pass thrown by Sean Hopkins, the junior.
It was a beauty. Here you go, John, take us through it.
Well, look at this. As Hopkins goes back, and I thought he was gonna run with the ball, but he's got McKay. Let's watch as he goes down. Now watch how he extends the arms. Beautiful pass and run. Number 8 goes in for a touchdown. 33 yards from Crane, from Mr. Hodgkin.
And there's your celebration. You know, John, as we watch McKay celebrate with Rosenfeld,
So that was Hopkins. Now,
you can't, you cannot defend that play. That was perfect. And
you know,
the play was made when McCabe come off the line. He got away from the defender coming off the line. A good break off the line, and it was a speed down the sideline.
You know, Larry, they got speed and size, and you got a great quarterback who can run a throw. So it's
formidable.
A winning combination.
Formidable. Line drive coming down, picked up by the up man. And he brings it up to about the 38-yard line.
Rakuski was there. And that was 20? Was that 20?
That's McCarrick again.
McCarrick. Ryan McCarrick.
This is our bracket where you have High Point, Westwood, Pequannock, and Mahwah. Right now, Mahwah's having their way with Pequannock.
I could put Mahwah in here.
You might as well start writing Mahwah in there. They're going back. Here's Phillip. Going around the left side. And he bangs his way across the 40-yard line.
Yards. Stopped by 56.
Mr. Brown.
LT Brown. LT Brown, that's his 71st tackle.
He's a tackling machine.
So he has 70 tackles. I tell you, when I was looking at the stats of both teams, it's amazing what these kids can do.
Tight formation for High Point. That looks like Maselli for about three.
Definitely 31.
Now you see, John, a team like High Point, when they get behind, they've got to be able to throw a couple of times just to loosen Westwood up. Because if they don't throw, Westwood's going to put 11 guys within 5 yards of that line of scrimmage.
Eight, nine in the box, they say. And that's what you have to do. You say you got to pass to beat us.
Third down and fourth.
But Maselli can run and run and run. 1,299 yards before
Phillip's
tonight.
In motion. Phillip going around the left side. And he is
stopped.
Close. He got to the sidelines. We've got to see where they punt that ball. It's far away from us.
It looks like it's going to be short. Right on the 40.
He looked like he stepped out of bounds.
Yeah, on the 45-yard line. Or?
So Sabo's going to kick it again, three and out. He may have lost the yard. Sabo will kick. McKay is back. He should get the ball between the 30, about the 25-yard line. But Sabo can get into this.
Well, he had a 48-yard punt first time.
Here's your snapback. Look at this kick.
Woo! Nice kick. Safe.
McKay's calling for a fair catch. He gets it somewhere on the 25-yard line. Westwood will take over. 20 on first and 10 on their 25-yard line. 14 to nothing with 1:49 to go. This is Dennis Hard, the coach at Westwood High School. What a crowd, and people still coming in.
I tell you, you have a lot of people here from High Point.
Yeah, they came out.
So you got trips to the left.
Hopkins.
And Hopkins.
Fourth to 35 to the 36.
Hopkins with six at the right side.
Well, 25. I'm going to give it to Rob Toro and Ryan McCarrick on the tackle. And that was what? 5 yards? 5+ yards.
Look at this. Kramer has it. Kramer gets across the 50-yard line. He was open in a nice seam, caught the ball, went across the 50-yard line.
Great throw. He's so big.
And
Joe Kramer.
And he is a junior.
He was 31 for 451 yards, 6 TDs before tonight's game.
And a junior.
And we'll be back to 6-5.
We'll be back with Hopkins next year. Oh, God.
What a combination that'll be.
What a program.
He's going to
get hit. Hopkins gets sacked from behind, and he's dropped. That was a sack.
And number 22, Gavin Hunziker. Hunziker. And this team, I tell you, they're strong up front, and they get plenty of sacks.
You know what they're going to have to do? I think they're going to have to, High Point's going to have to do a lot more of this blitzing, trying to disguise it, because you can't keep Hopkins back there with time.
with times, and he's got an option.
And he got an option to run, but he has these wide receivers. Visage is all the way to the right.
They're changing the play right here.
Yeah, they are.
So you got trips to the right.
Got one defense is one high. A run, nice block. Hopkins gets around the left side.
And you know who blocked? Mr. Rakuski. Mr. Rakuski.
Rakuski made a nice block there. Going to bring up a third down and wait for the spot.
You know, it looks like a train, you know. Rakuski, and then you got
we got a penalty. Illegal block.
Flag on the play.
I don't know by who, but we don't care about that in high school. But I was watching the way he just followed Rakuski. And number 12, Sean Hopkins, is trying to take him to the promised land, back to MetLife Stadium, possibly, or Kane.
These are all the semifinal games. There's some great games being played tonight all over northern New Jersey. I guess all over New Jersey. The winners will meet in 2 weeks, except if you're Northern Highlands. They have to play next week, Thanksgiving weekend, for them to get the finalists. And the games we played at MetLife Stadium, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, first week of December.
And we'll be there.
We will be there.
About 24 yards.
Oh, they're about more than that, maybe 30 yards. Hopkins.
Well, look at the room. There's plenty of room right there.
Hopkins looking, stays on his feet, and gets knocked out at the 25-yard line.
14-yard run.
So, nice run by Sean. This is Joe Kramer. Look at him.
Look at that young man smiling. But he, on the field, he's a tough guy, though. He's smiling right there. That's right. He likes math, so he uses math to be able to catch those passes.
Likes Notre Dame, dodgeball. Famous song is March Madness. I'm sure we all heard of March Madness.
He's a junior.
Right?
March Madness.
Yeah, we've heard it.
We've watched it for a lot of years. We remember when the first March Madness was.
McKay,
here comes to the other side.
The middle.
Look at it.
And McKay is stopped on the 45-yard line.
And they wanted a face mask.
So it's going to bring up a fourth down and five.
I go.
Fourth down and five.
No.
Kramer will kick.
That ends the first quarter.
And that will end the first quarter with Westwood leading 14-0 over High Point. You are watching WCTV's all volunteer access group from the Township of Washington, bringing you the semifinal playoff game between High Point and Westwood. The winner will move on to play the winner of Pequannock and Mahwa. And at this point, it looks like it's going to be Mahwa as they're having their way with Pequannock.
They're waiting for the winner of this game.
Hi, I'm Phil Sims, and you're watching WCTV, all-volunteer community television from the Township of Washington.
Hey, that's what I'm supposed to say. Why is he saying that?
He says it a lot better, Larry. He says it a lot better than you. Plus, I can see him with a big cigar.
This is part of our crowd. Thanks for Phil Sims. And this is our crowd. And I'm telling you, it is packed on both sides of the field. This could be one of the bigger crowds we've had here at Westwood. Kramer will kick, and he can kick. Believe me.
I wonder if he can cook. You think he can cook also?
The Dumont game. They were losing Westwood by six. He had a kick just like this. The receiver could not handle the punt. He muffed it. Westwood recovered it, scored a touchdown, and they won 21-20.
So they had three games in a row by 1 point.
That was a great kick.
It's unbelievable when all these games, they could have lost to Ramsey. They could have lost to,
Dumont.
Not Dumont, no.
Inglewood.
Yeah, Dwight Morrow. Yeah, Dwight Morrow.
Toro will drop back along with Phillip.
And then you had the 1 point.
Back for High Point.
Let me get the other point. Here we go. I got enough papers here, Larry.
Yeah, we have a lot of papers. We do.
Look at this. Here we go.
End over end kick. And it's taken by
Phillip.
This has been a team that started off the season 1-2. After losing overtime against Riverdale. Then they blew out Dumont. They came back and blew an undefeated at Richfield Park. Then they beat a very good Cedar Grove, 41-13. Then they went into the one-point victory game, 10-9 against Ramsey, 21-20 Dwymora, and 23-22 Lincoln. And last week, they went back to the 40, 42-12. I said a mouthful.
You sure did.
I hope you understood everything I said.
I did.
Okay, that's all it got.
Musinski wants to throw, now he wants to run.
He's another Puts runner.
Back. He could run too. And he gets across the 35-yard line. Anthony Carubia is in at the defensive back for the Cardinals.
Gaining 9 yards on first down.
And you know, Larry, you mentioned Leshinsky. He's got 505 yards before this game. Musili had 1,299, and Phillip had 536 yards. So they run the ball.
Well, I tell you, John, that's one of the better offensive plays so far for High Point. Picked up 9 yards, second and one.
You may even see a pass here. No. Let's see. No, he held
Musinski
the ball.
Musinski takes the play away. He put the ball in Muselli's hands, but kept it. And Pogge.
It's like the Honey Badger. Ow!
Mr. Pogge was there to stop it. And he dropped
the
him.
The Honey Badger.
Dropped him for a 2 yard loss.
And every time the Honey Badger makes a tackle, we have to growl. Ow!
That's not one of your better growls.
That was horrible. The rating the Italian judge gave me a 1 out of 10. I'll do better later.
The Honey Badger Union doesn't like that.
You're right.
According to Ida, Honey Badgers were on Channel 13. They did a documentary on it. Can you believe it?
So here's a big play right here.
That was penalty. And it looks like there's going to be against High Point.
You may. Let's watch the referee.
Motion against High Point. So High Point had the first play of this drive, pick up 9 yards. They're going the wrong way now. Now it's third down and 8 yards, 7 yards.
Now they have a pass here. They could pass. They're going to pass. You're going to have to run right with Lucinski.
There's the Honey Badger. Ricky had to put the Honey Badger up.
Look at the Honey Badger. Now look how mean. And the claws.
Joe, he looks like a happy little guy.
That's, are you kidding me?
Looks happy to me.
He's happy. He just ate something.
That's a PBS show they're telling us.
Here's your pass play.
Musinski wants. Throw downfield. Oh, he misses his man, Gilmore. He had Gilmore down there.
Yeah, that was.
So it's a fourth down now. Sabo will come in.
No and first downs, right?
No first downs here. They had a second and one.
Ready to receive.
Yeah, we're in the second quarter.
Westwood get pretty decent field position unless Zabo can really bang this out of here now. High Point needs a good punt here.
From the 30-yard line.
Nice kick. McKay will let it bounce. And it'll go out of bounds at the 38-yard line. Where Westwood will take over, first and 10. They lead 14 to nothing.
32 yards on the kick.
WCTV would like to thank the News Varsity 12 and HBFB Networks for allowing us to do the game. And ultimately, Liz Nodelin at the NJSIAA. They worked very hard this week with us to make this game available to cable access station WCTV. Thank you so very much. Here's John's friend going crazy.
Hi there. Honey Badger.
Hopkins, quarterback keeper, slips away from one would-be tackler and is hauled tied at the 45-yard line.
Six-yard carry from the 39 to the 45. We didn't mention the referees. The referee is Mike Probasco. The umpire is Mick Caswell, as my buddy is on the screen. Line judge, Mark Andrews. Lineman, Walt Levy. Back judge, Harry McMichael. Side judge, Brian Francis. And the clock operator, Paul D'Ascencio. Nice Italian name. And
Kramer,
a first down.
That's enough for the first down as he falls right in front of us across the 50. Marwa let the clock run out and wins 35-13 to go to the finals. The winner of this game will play Marwa in 2 weeks, either probably next Saturday.
Oh, wait a while.
So we know already that Mawa is the final, one of the finalists. Who will it be? High Point or Westwood? Stay tuned. First and 10 for the Cardinals.
It's the big drive for Westwood.
Hopkins fired downfield for Vicious and overthrows him at the 15-yard line.
Hopkins. Excellent blocking that time. This young man is getting more and more playing time.
And we know him.
Yes, we do.
We know him. We know him a long time.
But we can get. He's got 8 receptions, 71 yards, and 2 TDs. That's dad.
Bob Visich, who shoots the film here for
so
Westwood.
Visich has 2 touchdowns this year.
We have a timeout, I think, on the field. Let's see.
Runs nice patterns.
What do we got here?
A little chatting.
Timeout. No flag. Timeout at Westwood. 8 minutes, 45 seconds to go. Westwood will have a 2nd and 10 when Westwood play resumes. They lead 14-0. 2nd down. Lukeshek has. No, it's kept. Oh, Hopkins keeps it right up the middle, gets to the 45-yard line. What a sneaky little play that was by Hopkins. Got me going the wrong way. Third down, 6 yards to go for the Cardinals. Downey's in, number 49 for the Cardinals.
I had Jake Leshinsky on the stop on that. Number 9. That was a quick handoff. And a
Hopkins
fake.
Back. Throws. Has his man. And that looks
first
like
down. Number 8.
McKay with a first down. He picked up above 12. So it's a first down. And Westwood will move along here. We have an injured player on the field for High Point. 1st and 10 for Westwood. Hopkins rolling to his right. Throws downfield for Roosevelt. Knocked away.
Oh, that was great close. Job
Gilmore.
By D.
Almost made the interception.
Throws to Roosevelt, broken up by number 3, Gilmore.
This is the crowd across the way.
The
most of those people
crowd.
Are from High Point, and they have filled up the entire far side.
And there's some on this side, too.
Yeah.
I spoke with a couple of them when we came in. There's a group to our left. Sean Hopkins.
2nd and 10. Hopkins surveying the field. This time, location does have it, and he's hit immediately as he gets to the line of scrimmage.
Looks like number 15, Larry. I believe it was Connor Sibesma.
No gain on the play. 3rd down and 10.
Lukashik.
He's coming out. The wide receivers are coming in at 3rd and 10.
Yeah, that's Lightning Lukashik, they call him. 2 kickoff returns for touchdowns.
Hopkins calling signals. Has it, looks, gonna run.
What a hole right
there.
He's
got it for first down. He's at the 20, he's at the 15, 10, 5, touchdown. Touchdown, 38 yards.
38 yard touchdown. TD. Number 12, Sean Hopkins.
So Hopkins runs it in, 38 yards. And has this young man played on a high level the entire year? Throw that first game out, and from that 2nd game on, he has played fantastic.
Absolutely, Larry. And he was in 3 nail biters in the middle.
There he
goes the toe.
The toe knocks it through. So 7 minutes, 1 second to go. Westwood takes a 21-0 lead over High Point. You are watching a semifinal playoff game between High Point and Westwood, brought to you by WCTV, the all-volunteer access group from the township of Washington.
Here's your play as Hopkins gets the ball. He looks at number He looks to pass, but has he seen the big opening in the middle? The line did a great job. And once the young man from the 38, as he's going down, another block downfield by one of his receivers. Touchdown, Sean Hopkins. Score now is 20, extra points good. 21-0 in the second quarter. He's unbelievable the way he runs.
My God.
Bouncing ball. They better fall on it. Finally, someone did fall on it. Turo looks
Turo.
Like.
It was Turo, 25. And two went on top of him just to make sure. Tommy Gilmore.
So 7:01.
21-0, as you can see. The head coach, here.
Jim Delaney.
Nice young man. He's got a great program.
Yeah, you know, both these schools, they don't have teams, they have programs. There's a good foundation, good underclassmen.
He will be back next year.
Oh, they'll be back.
They got a great team.
Whoa. Sabo caught the ball and was drilled.
By 22.
Cuomo.
Cuomo, who's been out. Yeah, that's Zach the Governor Cuomo. You're right. Hey, that's his nickname. I knew I had a nickname. That governor.
Not the lieutenant governor.
The governor.
So second down and 13 has Cuomo. Lisinski calling signals. There's a mix-up there in the handoff. I don't know if he wanted to give it to him. He wanted to run, but Roselli took it and was dropped. For
that
about.
Was Benny the Jet Dada.
Oh, he's the Jet now, huh?
Yep. He's got 5 sacks. He leads the sophomore. Leads the.
You know, that was amazing when you told me that, going over the stats, that Benny Dada leads Westwood in sacks.
5 sacks. Whew. He's got that upper body strength. And his dad is right over there.
And his and John, he's a sophomore.
I know that.
A lot of sophomores here.
And this young man is a sophomore too. Lisinski.
Lisinski wants. Throw downfield. Incomplete. Some contact down there, but incidental.
Jake Phillips says, what's going on? He turns around. He says, how come I didn't got nothing? I didn't get a handkerchief. I needed a handkerchief.
Everybody was looking at it. Was there interference down here?
Benny the Jet.
Like
Benny and the Jet. Da da. Benny and the Jet.
He's going to start singing now. We're in trouble.
Got to keep the
Flow going, huh?
Yeah, absolutely.
Sabo kicks it. Nice end over end kick. McKay calls for a fair catch about the 40-yard line. Westwood will take over. 5 minutes, 33 seconds to go. They lead 21-0 over High Point. First and 10.
42.
On the 42-yard line. Hopkins back. Looks. Fires. Downfield for McKay again. He's got it. McKay to the 10, to the 5. Touchdown. Whoa, what a throw.
58 yards.
On the money again, McKay caught it, broke away from a would-be tackler, and strolled into the end zone for another touchdown, and Westwood goes up 27-0. Westwood is on all 8 cylinders tonight, and if you want to say...
What a throw, Larry. That was... You got to be kidding me. What a perfect throw.
Mike, what a throw is right.
Oh my goodness.
And what a catch. And McKay's just running by these defensive backs. Kick is up, and it is good. So, with 5 minutes, 23 seconds to go in the first half, Westwood takes a commanding 28-0 lead over High Point. You are watching WCTV, the all-volunteer access group in the town.
There it is, Larry, from the, as you can watch him, as you can see number 12 throwing the ball downfield. From the 42 to 58, now you'll see number 8, he catches the ball. And then he just extends an attempted tackle. He just eliminates that and goes in untouched. What a throw from Hopkins to McKay. 58 yards, 28-0.
He's too big, he's too fast, he's too strong, and he runs great routes. It's very difficult with these wide receivers. You're going to have a hard time defending them.
McKay's got two touchdowns, and his Kramer's got one touchdown.
And the way Hopkins is putting the ball on the money, that's McCarrick, I think, falling on it again. John, I am so much impressed with the way Hopkins is throwing this ball. Those balls are on the money. I mean, right on the money. You can't throw a ball. I don't know if you can throw a ball better than that.
No, that was perfect. Because there wasn't that much extension between the defender and the receiver. And then the ball was outstanding, stretch hand, and the receiver just kept going into the end zone.
Just pumping away. It's just amazing that Westwood is just on all eight cylinders, and they are playing just lights out.
And this team that they're playing is an excellent team. An excellent team.
This is Mosell. Nope. Stepped inside.
Uh-oh.
Little fist to come down there.
Well, that was Cliff Rutter and 76.
Phillip with the run. Down there.
Brendan Sullivan.
Sullivan was in the, he was in the middle of everything.
Has a great season. Brendan Sullivan, a senior. 6'3", 225.
Boy, he plays well. Just steady every game.
Every game. Makes the plays. Great blocking.
Does the work that has to be done.
And plays defense.
Right.
Well, great fake that time. Faked everybody out.
Maselli took it off the right side. You know, high point, I hate to say this, it's third down and 3 yards to go. They don't have a first down. And we got 4 minutes and 32 seconds to go.
I think they're going to have a first down this time.
You get that feeling?
That's my prediction.
All right.
Was it third and two? Third and two. Let's see. Let's see if I'm right. Well, maybe not.
Maybe we'll have a timeout.
Timeout. Looks like. No?
Nope.
I give it to number 31 for the first down. Chad Maselli.
It's Maselli.
Not good.
Stopped.
Chad Maselli has 102 points for the season. 1,299 yards before this game.
That was Brandon Brown and Wydell in the middle of that. It's fourth down and one.
LT Brown?
I think Coach Delaney, I think he's going to go for it.
He's got it. Larry, he's got it. He's got to give it back to 31. Maselli, he's their big leader.
You go. You give it to him.
Give it to Maselli.
Tell that line to move everybody off the ball and pick up this first down with 3:35 to go. Fourth and a long one.
Let's see if number 31 gets the ball. No, the quarterback.
He's going to have it for a first down as
that
he gets
is a first
across
down.
The 40-yard line.
So I was right. One first down he got. That's good. That was the quarterback.
That's a quarterback.
Quarterback sneak. He's a sophomore. He's got a brother. It's number 9 and, of course, number 24. So you have two, Lucchesi.
And they, the quarterback and the tight end.
They're both sophomores. He's got an unbelievable young underclassmen that are going to make a great team next year. A lot of them will be seniors. And they'll be back in this playoff. Good fake.
Turo. And Turo gets about the 40-yard line where he is tackled very quickly by Wotuski and company.
76 trombone is in there. and Steve Rydell, who had 27 tackles before today, the sophomore. Now it's Sullivan. That's pretty good. 76 trombone. Sullivan.
Sullivan again.
That's a new nickname, 76 trombone.
Well, it took 8-9 games to get that one.
Well, you know, I'm 74, so the mind doesn't work as well.
Oh, tell me about it. Maselli looking, throws out here to Turo, and Brown gets him for a loss. Whoa.
LT Brown. 74 tackle for the season.
Brown with the tackle.
What a ball play he is. LT Brown.
He is such an outstanding linebacker.
And a guard. He plays guard.
Plays guard, yep.
But he's... that's where he should play at the next level, depending on where he goes.
I think Turo was injured on that play. When we come back, there'll be 2 minutes and 15 seconds to go. High Point will be looking at a 3rd and 12. They trail 28-0 to Westwood.
Here's the cheerleaders, Larry.
Here's our cheerleaders at Westwood. Turo went off the field under his own power. That's always good to see. Thank God. You always worry. It's third down and very long, 13. Phillip is in motion. He hits the ball, and he is stopped right away as he tried to get around the
left side. Pick up underneath. Here's the man who made the stop.
Mr. Carter,
90. Another young man has been playing outstanding. Roy Carter.
Fourth down now. Zabo will come in to kick. There's your score. There's your time. Westwood calls a timeout to preserve some time on the clock. They think they could do some damage here before the half. They lead 28-0. John, I don't know how much better Westwood could play. At Hopkins is at a level that, you know, we've seen some great quarterbacks in our time, but the last couple of weeks, he is right there with some of these quarterbacks.
Larry, his stats, he came into this game with a 63% completion. If we did it, it's got to improve. The number of touchdowns, plus he runs, he is a wrecking machine by himself, you know, and he's got these two outstanding receivers right now. How are you going to stop this offense?
We haven't seen Lukaszczyk run. If you try to stop the receivers, they have the runners with Lukaszczyk and Lutucki, and then Hopkins is a runner.
And Cuomo can come in.
Yeah. You know, this offense is really, really percolating.
On all cylinders, as they say.
Zabo will kick.
He may get the athlete of the week.
He could be. He'll be in the running.
First half, he's got something. almost blocked. I think that was tipped. Oh, look at that catch.
What a great catch on the sideline.
Well, that's Cuomo. That's the governor. It's the governor.
He catches on the field and off the field.
Governor, look at him. He's getting high fives, shaking hands. He just came back. He was injured. He's happy to play. And Zach Cuomo will be back, the governor. He's been christened the governor tonight by WCTV. And not me, the whole WCTV.
He's a junior?
He's a junior. He'll be back, the governor.
Hopkins, we have a flag on the play. That boy's coming back.
Look at
Westwood, as he is hit across the 30-yard line. Let's see what the call's going to be. Let's see. Motion against Westwood. Somebody was moving forward before the snap.
Franco did a nice tackle on number 12 Hopkins. He says, I can put you down.
So the ball will go to the 50-yard line where it'll be a first down and 15 yards to go.
You know, I have to compliment the officials. They're doing a great job. You don't even know they're there. And there have only been a couple of penalties. This is a great group of...
And let's tell them where they are. They're all the way down from South Jersey, right?
Yep.
They came all the way up on a 2.5-hour ride.
Part of the Southern Chapter. And what a job. And to me, they have to be there. Make the call. You don't even know they're there. They're invisible. That's exactly right. Bird told me that, invisible.
They came from all the way down in Southern New Jersey, 2.5-hour ride. Hopkins didn't see anybody, so he takes off and gets across the 50-yard line. The rule is, very quickly, John will explain to people, when you have playoff games, you don't have the officiating crews in the same area. You move them. So the Bergen County referees and officials, they'll move down to South Jersey, Cape May, Atlanta County, Cumberland. They'll move them all around, and vice versa.
Second and 13.
Well, back to
here's McKay. McKay's in the open. He's going to be gone. He's at the 15, 10, 5, 4, 3, 1. Down to the 1 yard line.
1 yard line. So from the 48, 2 and 49 is 51 yards on a little, well, not a bubble screen, but a 2 yard pass. 51 yards on that play.
And Hopkins keeps rolling it up. Hopkins goes to the goal line. Let's wait for the signal. It's very close. He's in.
Hopkins.
So Sean Hopkins runs it in.
1 yard TD.
And Westwood now puts up 34 points in the first half.
Unbelievable speed by number 8, Kramer. was it McKay, right?
McKay caught the ball.
McKay.
Those inside screens, almost a bubble screen. Got it down to the one, and Hopkins took care of the last yard.
I thought it was, you know, those two, sometimes I make a mistake between the two of them, but that was McKay, right?
The pass, yes. The kick is good. So with 47.5 seconds to go, Westwood has come out rolling and steaming as they take a 35-0 lead over High Point here on the campus of Westwood High School in Washington Township. This is for semifinal playoff game. The winner will play Mahwah in 2 weeks.
Well,
this is your
number 12. As you see, Hopkins makes a short pass, a bubble screen.
There's your 76 trombone.
Yeah, with 76 trombone
Sullivan
with a block.
Big block.
And this is number 8, Sean McKay. Makes the catch, goes 51 yards. And look at this as he extends as number 23. Hunziker tackles him to the second yard, to about the 2 yard line. And then a 2 yard run by Hopkins for a touchdown. So the score is now 35-0.
We just got some stats from our statistician, Nick Spook, doing it for the high school. Sean Hopkins, John, 10 for 16, 232 yards and 2 touchdowns. He has 14 rushes for 115 yards. McKay has 6 catches for 165.
We should keep that. That's unbelievable stats.
Now you know why they're up 35-0. So 36.6 seconds to go. It's been all Westwood, 35-0. As we get close to closing out the first half.
So we have, what a half. Larry, what a half. With those stats, Hopkins adds to his percentage.
Wow, that's good for, I tell you what, John, you have that for a game and you did well.
And this is a half. You know what? I'm gonna go on the line to say.
Dada, big stop.
Dada, with a sack?
Nope, big stop.
You know, we have to mention his nickname again. It's Benny the Jet Dada.
Oh, I beg your pardon.
Benny the Jet Dada.
I beg your pardon.
Benny the Jet Dada. We can make a song out of that.
We could.
But, you know, you look at Hopkins. He's been knocking on the door for Player of the Week. Now, you know what? Right now.
This should be the last play if they get it off. Hold it. That's it. The play didn't get off. So the half comes to an end. Westwood leads High Point 35-0 as the first half comes to an end. You are watching WCTV, the All Volunteer Group from the Township of Washington. We'll be back with the second half kickoff in just a moment.
For the final time this football season, please center your attention. On the 50-yard line, as we welcome to the field your very own 2016 Westwood Cardinal cheerleaders, coached by Brittany Rubino. We'll be right back.
back here. Halftime's over. Westwood leads 35-0. John has some stats, and I have some information for you.
Well, let me just start from the first quarter. We had Kramer, a touchdown pass from Hopkins for 12 yards, and the score, extra point, was good. Then you had a 33-yard TD McKay from Hopkins, so that's two passes. 14-0. The toe made it 14-0. Start the second quarter, 38-yard touchdown. Again, number 12, Hopkins, a run this time. Extra point good, 58-yard touchdown from Hopkins to Sean McKay, 28-0. Then you had a 51-yard catch for McKay, and then Hopkins, 2-yard touchdown, extra point was good, 35-0. And we mentioned some of the individual earlier. Hopkins right now is 10 for 16, 232 yards and 2 touchdowns, 14 rushes for 115 yards, 3 TD, and McKay, 6 catches for 165 yards. Hopkins will be player of the week this week, coming up.
We will start the second half, and under the rules of the NJSIA, we will have a special procedure on the clock. The clock will run continuously except for a timeout, a score, an injury, or a penalty. If none of those things take place, the clock will continue to run. If the score reverts less than 35, high point scores a touchdown, we go back to regular time, and this rule will end. So right now we're in a mercy rule, as they call it. Timeout, score, injury, or penalty will only stop the clock, not even change the possessions, I was told. So basically, that's what's going to happen. Now, if High Point should score even a field goal and the spread comes less than 35 points, then we revert back to regular time.
And right now, Larry, well, you don't want no injuries.
No.
You want to get the game over, you know, and you live for another day as Westwood will get ready as Mawa is in. Waiting for the winner, which should be Westwood.
We have some score. I mean, there's some games on. Paramus Catholic and Don Bosco are within, I think it's a point now, 21-20. Riverdale and, who we got up there?
He's hiding behind.
Oh, that's Kevin. That's one of our interns, Kevin from Westwood. How are you, Kev?
Kevin wore a jacket, or else he would have worn my jacket.
Oh, he was cold last time we had a game.
As Emily was doing the great
job. How about
that
Ramapo Riverdale, all tied up, as we heard? Here's Emily. She's ready for the snowstorm that's coming Sunday. So the teams are on the field now. We're getting ready for the kickoff. Let's see, there's Ida. And there's our other member of WCTV, John's Honey Badger.
My Honey Badger. He's talking to me right now. He said, stay cool, stay under control. I'm ready. I'm going to eat fine today.
He's such a happy-go-lucky guy, isn't he?
Absolutely. I take him to bed with me. My wife gets mad, though. The honey badger's in between us. He pushes my wife away. Look at it. He says, you see the way he's looking at me? He says,
he's watching
I'll see
the game,
you tonight.
John.
I'll see you tonight.
How could you say he's a nasty animal? Well, nice looking.
But look,
animal.
He says, look the way he wants to give me a little kiss right now.
Lou, you better be careful.
Watch the honey badger. Oh, my goodness. Make sure, take care of my honey badger. That's my little pet when I go to bed. The life at the Francola house. The honey badger.
Well, we'll be back with the opening kickoff in just a moment. We are back and ready for the kickoff. Gilmore is deep. In front of him is, it's like Sabo, not a move. Krajcik. McCarron's back. Ball is coming down and picked up by. Is that Gilmore down there?
We'll pick him up.
kickoff return by number
No, that's Phillip. So Phillip has the run up. Like I said, the clock is running now. It'll run. The ball is on the 34-yard line. Westwood leads 35-0.
And Larry, I'll tell you, right next year, this team that you see out here, High Point, will be back in the playoff.
Oh, they're very young. It's a good program. Great coaching and a good foundation there.
Delaney does a great job at
Gilmore
this group.
On a off took the ball off the wing, hit the middle. Carter was there, along with Dada and Rydell.
You know, Larry, we have to mention, too, another great football coach, Bay Mongelia, retired at Cliffside Park after 3 years, feels that someone should be in the program. I told him, you know, you should look for another area, and he's a great coach, a great builder of men. So good luck to you, Babe, on TV.
Babe Mongelia, good friend of ours. Phillips in motion. This is Jensensky. Looks, the ball is batted away by Poggi.
Number six, Matt Poggi, the Honey Badger. He steps up in big games. That's Mr. Poggi, the Honey Badger.
Third down and 8 yards to go.
I banged the window by the Honey Badger.
How do you like this, Riverdale and Mamaport?
I just banged the window. I got even with that. Mr. Poggi.
Made him jump, huh?
Yeah. All right, so I got out of control.
Ridgewood and Ramapo all tied at half.
That's some game.
21-21.
Nice fake by the quarterback.
Wilsinski, he hits, and boys, he's stopped in there. And that is
76.
At Sullivan. Big stop. Sullivan stayed his ground, played it well. McKay will drop back to get Sabo's kick. Points with all Westwood.
76 trombone, right? That's 76 trombone Sullivan. They've had a great game at the line today. Another punt for...
Snap comes back a little low.
The Wildcats.
And a whistle.
Let's see.
Ooh, you know, John, I don't know. That could have been dangerous. What? High Point was offside. That ball had a chance of being blocked.
They almost blocked the last
one.
Yeah,
Westwood had a good run on that.
Yeah. The one thing you don't want, anybody getting hurt today. And this young man, a sophomore, Grayson Sabo, punts, kicks. He's also backup quarterback.
Snap comes back.
Oh, my goodness.
That ball came out crazy.
But it's got a great bounce.
Roll and come to at the 32-yard line where Westwood will take over. First and 10. They lead 35-0. Clock is running with 8 minutes and 57 seconds to go in the third quarter. So let's see what we do here, John.
Well, yeah, 33-yard punch is... Nice punt, nice bounce. Well, now we see what will Westwood do at this point.
Hopkins calling signals. Hopkins will run. Gets away to the 40, cuts inside to the 50, to the 40, and to the 35-yard line.
33 yards.
And another 33 yards to Mr. Hopkins' numbers.
Yep. 148, 15 rushes, 148 for Hopkins, and 3 TDs.
Throw out here. And that looks like number one, Kramer, for a pickup of about 8. Another 8 yards. There's Joe Kramer. Second down and 2 yards, 3 yards to go.
He'll be back next year. A junior, 6'5", 2 over. Oh, my God. Get that honey badger.
That guy's looking for the honey badger. the honey badger. Handoff inside. Should it be enough for a first down? That looks like it might have been Latusky. Oop.
God, look
now,
at this.
What is that?
I have no idea.
Whoever he is, he's chasing someone.
I think he's after the honey badger.
There he goes, right by us.
Look at him. Look at him. He almost fell. Oh, now he's dancing.
We know that's not that guy. He's not looking for Vito Trous, is he? He looks hungry too. First down. Visage has a pitch bouncing around, and he gets to the 20-yard line.
58. Shane Ratz on the stop. He's looking for some food. He's going to come up here. You know, we got food up here. We got
no
cookies.
More, no, those cookies are gone. Down, down.
Oh, my goodness. Look at this. He wants some meat.
Six minutes and 30 seconds to go. Third quarter. Clock is running. Westwood leads 35-0. They're looking at a second and seven. Here's your clock. Here's the Westwood cheerleaders. Hopkins has time and just overthrows Kramer. That's got to be tough to throw Kramer. He's 6'5".
It was about a yard too far. That's the kind of pass you want to make. The receiver's got to get it. But he dove and couldn't come up with it. That could be one of the last passes he may have tonight. We got to give a lot of credit to that front line.
Oh,
you
know what,
John? Right across.
You're absolutely right there. They've done a great job giving Hopkins a lot of time.
Zeltner at center, 51. You got them all, the starters there. We can repeat.
Let's get this play off and get them up there.
Yeah, you know, everything starts with the offensive line. Rakuski a fake. And
Hopkins gets to the 15. It's going to bring up a short fourth down and maybe a yard. Let's see what the spot's going to be. Yeah, the offensive line, Zeltner, Sullivan, Brown, Petunas, and Henry. What a job they've done. Quickly. And I believe Hopkins has enough for the first down as he gets across the 15.
2 yards. He now has 17 carries, 158 yards, and 3 touchdowns.
Hey, John, why don't you throw that guy down there, the last slice of pizza we have. Oh, look at that.
Look at this. The honey badger wants it.
I think he's in love.
That could be a marriage made in heaven. Or in hell. Maybe in hell is better.
You took the words right out of my mouth.
Yeah. I was trying to be nice.
Hopkins is having a career night here. What a job. Lukasik has been quiet because Hopkins is firing the ball and the passing is doing well. But Cole gets around the right side and falls to about the 5-yard line.
McCarrick on the stop and Lukasik gained about 8 yards on the play. We don't have stats on that. I'm just keeping stats on Sean Hopkins.
Second down and 2 yards to go. Oh, Lukasik going to go on the left side. He's going to the goal line. He will. Does he get in? Yes, he's in. Cole Lujanczyk runs it in for a touchdown.
From what, the 13-yard line?
So Westwood now takes a 41-0 lead.
Westwood extends their lead with 4:09 left in the third.
Over High Point, it's been all Westwood. From they took the opening kickoff and went for a touchdown and scored within 4 minutes, and they haven't looked back. Everything they've tried has worked. And defensively, they have stopped the running game of High Point. They got in front, and that was just about it. So with 4 minutes, 9 seconds left in the third quarter, Westwood leads High Point 42-0. Semi-final game here for Group 2. The winner moves on to play Mahwah, and I think we can say with some certainty it'll be Westwood and Mahwah in 2 weeks, either Friday or Saturday, more likely on a Saturday. But don't
take it
for
at MetLife Stadium.
Well, they played once at MetLife Stadium for a championship against Waldwick, and they played once at Kane College. It all depends.
We were there.
We were both places. This is the huge crowd that has been here tonight. It is one of the biggest crowds. It could be the biggest crowd of the year, I think. We can't see it because we're
they're
all under us.
The other side is all full people.
Here's Freddie Kubia. No, just to the left. One more to the left.
Got to go to
just
the left.
Just go to the left. These are the Zeltners. And to the left, you have there's Fred Kubia. His grandson is a cornerback and quarterback. I should say that again slowly. Cornerback and quarterback. Here is Fred. Fred is the former police chief of Paramus.
Looking nice, and he enjoyed the touch or the interception that Fred Kubia made last week.
Fred's job now is to try to find my brother Sal.
That's tough.
Oh, nobody knows where he is. So I worked there for the New York City Police Department, and he's a security expert. He can't find my keys sometimes over my house, but he's a security expert. But since he wants to run, he has some room, gets to the outside, and gets the first down as he gets across the 40-yard line.
Very nice job by number 9, Lushinsky.
There we are in the back.
There we are right there. Look at those old guys.
There's Mr. Poggi. He is the outgoing president of the Touchdown Club. Next year, there'll be a new president.
He says he's going to stay.
Yeah.
He has so much fun.
Sullivan, I
had to hit the window.
Coach Hart is going might be taking some of his plays out. Sullivan just came up. Here he is, Mr. Poggi. There's the original.
I think I'm going to get the honey
Look
badger.
Look at John over there.
I'm going to get the honey badger on him. Good, nice fake by the quarterback.
Yeah, the quarterback kept it. That's Lushinsky.
The sophomore, Jake Lushinsky. I guess the twins, right? The two.
Yeah, they are. These are the Westwood coaches in the booth next to us.
Eileen O'Sullivan right there, right in front with the W on the hat.
We want to thank her all year, the help she's given us here at the Westwood Games with the rosters. And any of the questions we may have comes right back to us.
And thank for her, I was able to get the athletic director.
Dan Favino. Pass outside to Phillip. Phillip gets away. And he's fighting his way down close to the 40 yards. Gets across the 40-yard line.
So Jake Phillip, nice run and a first down, right?
That should be enough for a first down.
Couple more people coming in.
Yeah, Westwood will start bringing some people out.
Tyler Downing, 49 in. Nick Baez, 2.
First and 10 for High Point. Lushinsky picked up a couple of yards.
Number 90, that's Roy Carter on the stop.
There's the indomitable Vito Trous, WCTV's SID. And he'll keep saying, don't say those letters. I don't know what they mean.
He said, watch him a call.
That's a higher call.
Higher call.
Vito's our sports information director. He gives us a lot of information. Wrong.
Everything that we say is from him. Wrong.
Wrong.
We just discount what he says. Yes.
Lushinsky looks, throws, has his man, and the ball's dropped. Oh, looked like he had it. The young man was ready to turn around.
That was
run.
Trevor Kocher on the almost the reception.
So it's a third down and 7 yards to go as we're inside 40 seconds as the clock continues to run.
Oh,
this is Heather Henry. And everybody here at WCTV would like to thank her so very much for the graciousness she showed from the first game when Marwa came here, bringing us coffee and some cookies. The ball's...
And Larry, you ready for this? She told me, I asked her, what did you think Westwood was going to do this year? She said, John, without a doubt, I felt that they would go to MetLife Stadium and regain, get a game against Marwa. Can you believe that? She's also a soothsayer, right?
Just to say thank you so very much. It meant so much to the volunteers, many of them coming from work, to come to the press box and have a hot cup of coffee.
Oh, my goodness.
It was very nice of you, and we appreciate it. The fourth quarter is in the books. Westwood is just 12 minutes away from a trip to the championship as they lead High Point 42-0.
Hey, hi, I'm Phil Sims, and you're watching WCTV, all-volunteer community television from the township of Washington.
Hey, John. And let's see who got the sack on that one.
Carter with the sack.
So Carter gets a sack.
Carter'll take over.
And Westwood will take over.
To start this fourth quarter.
So we're inside the, getting ready for the 11-minute mark. Anthony Carubia, the sophomore, will come in and take over the reins the last 11 minutes of this game as Sean Hopkins' night is over and a very productive one it was indeed. This is Baez for about a yard.
I was just trying to come up with some stats. So the night is over
for Hopkins.
So he finishes 17 carries, 158 yards, 3 TD rushing, and I'll get the number of passes. And three touchdown passing, I believe. Hold on. I will do that.
John's digging through his stats here. Westwood will drain every second of the clock. The clock will continue to run. We're over the 35-point differential between two teams, and the clock will run. Been this way the entire half. Pitch out. And Baez gets across the 50-yard line. It gives me a chance now because time is going to run, and we're going to run out of time. We at WCTV, the all-volunteer group, would like to thank so many people for helping us. And boy, as volunteers, we need a lot of help from the coaches and the assistants here to get these games on. We'd like to thank Jeff Remo for his help. Also, Brooks Alexander. These are all the coaches that gave us help throughout the year. Ted Evans from Dumont. Peter Klejak from Richfield Park. We caught him putting the television and cameras up on the upstairs. We couldn't find him. He was up there. He said that's a superstition he has. Hand off to Baez. He hits the line and is thrown right back. James Delaney, the outstanding. And we got a flag. That's going to be a personal foul. And let's see. As they sort this out, let me go through this because this is so important for everyone here to thank so many people to help us. Personal foul against High Point. James Delaney, the coach of High Point. He had a tough night tonight, but he has a wonderful program. He does not have a team. He has a program. It's a young team. They will be back. Danny Sabella, in his first year at Paramus Catholic, who helped us so much in doing our meatball game. Rich Hansen from St. Peter's. We go back a long time with Coach Hansen. Back to 1989, we did our first championship game, St. Peter's against St. Joe's. Nunzio Campanelli, what could you say? We know the Campanelli so well. Vito was a coach here. Nunzio's the coach at Bergen Catholic. All our friends at Bergen Catholic. Augie Hoffman, for all the help at St. Joe's they gave us when we had these shows that we were doing. We didn't cover the games up there, but we were doing some shows and getting stats from them, and he was always very, very nice to us. And of course, the head coach here, Dennis Hart, who has put together a wonderful program. His underclassmen are doing very well. The freshman team over the last couple of years has done very well. And now Dennis has piloted this team to a championship. Outstanding coach and outstanding gentleman. You like to see good things happen to good people, and good things happen tonight for a very fine person. So we congratulate Dennis Hart. The AD here, Danny Vavino, thank you so much. He's been so helpful to us any way possible. So, tell you, we could never do these games without the help of all of these people. And of course, most important, the student athletes who gave us so many thrills during this football season. There's one more chapter to write, and that'll be done in 2 weeks. WCTV will not be able to cover the play-by-play of any of the playoff games. The News Varsity, News 12 Varsity has total responsibility of those games. They will probably do all of the games in New Jersey and put them on their website. You have to check their website for the time and the date. But we will follow Westwood. We will follow the schools that we covered and try to do a show. Also, Bobby Maines for all the help he's getting. We'll get back to Bobby Maines. We'll go to see. We'll be at MetLife on the field covering some of the games, doing interviews, and maybe have a wrap-up show when everything is over. So to all those people, and especially the student athletes of all the schools that gave us so many thrills for our 30th year of covering high school football, from all of us, we say thank you. Thank you so very much. It was a wonderful ride, as usual, and we had the best seat in town, right, John?
Absolutely, Larry. I was just trying to get some stats on Mr. Hopkins, you know, and this game he ended up with 17 rushes, 158 yards, and 3 TDs. Passing, 10 for 19, 244, 2 TDs. for the season, Larry, he has 24 touchdown passing and 12 touchdown rushing. What a career. That's a career for a quarterback.
And if I missed anyone, and that's always possible, I do apologize. So many people, Rich Poggi and the people here, and just amazing, all the people that helped us. Carl Haas up at Westwood. I mean, at Bergen Catholic. The cheerleaders who worked so hard day in and day out. The band who's played so well for us. And these are all the cheerleaders for the schools that we covered. They make it so vibrant, the game. The bands that perform and work so hard. A lot of people go into making these games what they are. Hey, Kalubi goes around the end and he gets knocked out of bounds at the 10-yard line. As we get to the 5 minute and 39 seconds. So now Westwood will go to the championship game against Marwa. It's fitting, John, that the first game played that we covered was Marwa at Westwood, and it's going to end Marwa at Westwood, either at MetLife or King College. We'll know probably Sunday night, Monday morning, where the venue will be.
And it should be one heck of a football game.
Oh.
Because both teams are playing on their A game, 100%. They're both moving.
Certainly are. Baez around the right side, and he's tripped up. The way it's been, and we're guessing now, the way it's been, the Group 2 North usually plays 10 o'clock on Saturday.
That'd be a
at MetLife.
The last time we were there, we did that nice pregame from the outside MetLife Stadium.
Yeah, last year, Marwa won their championship. Was a 10 o'clock game.
Correct.
Now, all we have to hope for is nice weather. We don't need a snowstorm, ice storm, rainstorm, windstorm.
And we've been there when we've it's been that way.
We've been there in all kinds of weather.
So this is Carubia handing off to Baez.
And Baez hits to the 15-yard line. We're coming down to the last 4 minutes of this game. Let's go through WCT people who've been here throughout the year. Emily, thank you so very much. Does a great job. We got to get a picture of Ricky so they can see us. You know, when Liz Nodeland wants to know who's doing the work here from NJSIAA, we show these people. John and I, we don't show ourselves because we don't want them to know who we really are.
We're incognito.
Yeah. There's Ricky. Ricky. We got him. All right.
He gives me all the funny things. You know,
Ricky,
he's the one, he's the instigator.
Wait. This is the man that entices John. He keeps laughing and keeps John going.
Enticing.
If Ricky didn't laugh, Baez gets to the 5-yard line. If Ricky didn't laugh, John wouldn't carry on as much. But Ricky just keeps laughing and laughing and laughing.
You know what? Here's where I would put some knees at this point. What do you think? A couple of knees at this point at the scores.
He's not part of WCTV.
Look at this. Look at these. Look at the way he's dancing. He's a little bit slow. He's got all those arms.
You know what? He's trying to impress the honey badger upstairs.
And the honey badger may see him later. You can hear him talk language. There he is. He's talking to the honey badger. Look at this. Oh, my goodness. He's going up to see the honey badger.
Baez is knocked down at the 5-yard line.
That was number 59, Clint Rudder. Look at this, he's coming upstairs.
Oh, don't make him come up
here.
Where's
the honey badger?
So again, we're thanking everyone. This game is just about over. The clock is down to about 2 minutes and 40 seconds to go. The clock is running. The Westwood fans are very happy. And Westwood will now prepare for the next 2 weeks against Marwa. It is fitting, John. They opened up the two strong schools, and Marwa won the first one. I think it was 24-0.
Unbelievable. You know, this is high school at its best.
The Cincy takes it herself. Tackle made by John Frick.
Lisinski, we're going to go down. John and I are going to fight our way downstairs, try to get Dennis Hard. And we don't want to talk to the dinosaur. No, we're not interviewing no dinosaur. The Westwood players They'll be hooping and hollering in a few minutes. Game will be over. Phillip gets knocked out of bounds, shy of the 20-yard line. We're at the 1 minute and 30 seconds.
And Larry, just to give you a total on Hopkins. Passing, 1,982 yards passing. Rushing, 1,901 yard rushing. So you put the two together, that's 38-83 total running and passing from Mr. Hopkins.
Westwood go to 9-2. That's a big run by Musili as we get to the inside the minute. So Musili runs it up. And the Westwood stand crowd is beginning to stand and cheer this outstanding performance by the Cardinals of Westwood. Coach Hart has them right where he wants them. And I'm sure Jeff Primo up at Marwa has his team exactly where he wants them. Both teams are coming in, firing on all eight cylinders.
And we're going to try to get a hold of Mr. Hopkins and the head coach.
We're at the 19-second mark. This will be the last play of the game. End around. Gilmore staying on his feet. Staying on his feet. Gets to the 50-yard line. That will do it. And the game is over. And Westwood will move on to the championships against Marwa as they defeat High Point 42-0. John and I were going to make our way on the field and get a couple of interviews.
Congratulations to the High Point Wildcats for a great season. And congratulations to the Westwood Cardinals for their continued success. Senior cheerleaders and senior football players, please remember to take your signs home with you. Senior band members, cheerleaders, and football players, please do not leave the field without taking your signs.
Well, we're here with the head coach, Dennis Hart. It was like almost like an oil machine, yeah. Right? One right after another, one right after another. The running, the passing. Hopkins, I didn't see him better tonight than ever before. He really was on tonight.
No, he was phenomenal. I mean, the balls he threw were right on the money. They had a couple times they had great coverage. He put the ball right in there. Offensive line, great job. They never touched him. And, you know, him running the ball, he's got great set of wheels, and you've seen he had probably over 100 yards rushing, too. So.
Well, John's got some stats for you.
Tell you exactly what he had. He had 17 rushes for 158 yards, three TDs. He was 10 for 19 passing for 244 and two TDs. Right now, this young man, if you unofficial, passing 1,982 yards and 24 touchdowns, rushing 1,901 yards, rushing 12 touchdowns.
Wow, that you said a mouthful. That's a lot of yards. Sounds like athlete of week to me.
I
hope so. This, you know, we don't want to go 0 for 3. He definitely deserves it now.
But he is a tremendous offensive weapon, both running the ball and passing. He opens up a lot for you, doesn't he?
Oh, absolutely. But I mean, don't take anything away from the receivers. Joe Kramer, Sean McKay had a great game. Ryan Visage has some catches, and Jordan Rosen did a great job too, catching the ball.
What I saw tonight, though, with the two big guys, 6'5 and 6'3, 1-8, with Hopkins carrying the ball or passing, this is an offense that's going to be tough to stop.
Yeah, well, you know, we hope so. I mean, we got to do it one more time, and big rematch
playing,
coming up.
Right?
Yeah, absolutely.
we can tell you you're playing them.
What's that name?
Yeah, yeah.
what's your schedule now over the next 2 weeks? So pull back a little bit, work. How are you going to work?
Yeah, we'll probably rest up a little bit, you know, start up in the middle of the week, and then get it going again.
Okay.
So you know what I saw? After that game with Marwa, there was a learning process. You went into Riverdale. You should have won that game.
Oh, sure.
And that was 17, fourth down, 17 yards, and they scored a touchdown, the extra point.
But you know what? It all started then. In those three games.
No, I mean, that's what catapulted us. And we set it right on the field that night. And the kids believed. They bought into it. And
Yeah, but then you went 40-point wins.
Right.
And then all of a sudden you 1 point, 1 point, 1 point.
Yeah, we had those
and
three
then
one.
42-12.
Yeah.
And tonight, a perfect game.
Yep. You're doing it's a wonderful job. Keep up the good work. It's one more step to go. You'll find out probably Sunday where you go to play game. And then I'm sure all this crowd, you had a tremendous crowd, they will follow you.
Yeah, you've done
a great job, Coach. It really is. You've seen this team really progress from that first week. Congratulations. All the best.
Appreciate
and we'll follow you.
Great job.
Take care. Congratulations.
Okay. We'll see you at, hopefully, MetLife Stadium.
Hopefully.
Okay, we have to wait for Brian Carr.
What is going on here?
Brian Carr over here has got... doing the interview. Maybe he wants a microphone and we'll do it with him.
I'm going to have to ask this young man if this is correct.
Well, I think he would know. All right, we're going to be right back with Sean Hopkins as soon as he finishes with some interviews on the side. Well, we're here with the star of the show, Sean Hopkins. John's going to read some stats off for you, and this is what you did tonight.
Here's what you did tonight. You rushed for 17 times for 158 yards and 3 TDs. Not bad. Then you pass 10 for 19, 244 yards, and 2 TDs. So you had another 5 TD
night. Let me ask you, did you feel that you had it tonight when you came out, that everything was working well in practice?
This week of practice, we had a great week of practice this week. I mean, everything was working well. I mean, we were definitely clicking tonight. And, I mean, the way the line played today, I mean, on all phases, like, you know, they just did great run and pass, and the receivers kept getting open, our backs kept finding holes. I mean, you can't really ask for more after that.
How about the job Rakuski did for you to block on some of your runs? Is he unbelievable, young man?
I mean, what would you do if you saw that big guy come at you?
I mean, I go right behind him.
That's what I'm saying. Exactly. I mean, I love that kid so much. I mean, he's a great player, and I mean, there's no one else to run behind.
But where did you learn how to run the ball the way you do? You seem like you stop, you wait for your blocking, you don't get hit too hard too many times.
I mean, I don't know. Maybe it's great coaching,
I guess.
You'd
be a heck of a dancer. Yeah.
You did a nice job with the runs with Petusky. You cut off his block, you did well. But the passes you threw, we mentioned it on the game, and the coach mentioned it. I don't think I've seen a quarterback in a game throw a ball any better. You were on, even the passes that were slightly overthrown, you were right on the money. Inches or fingertips. There was one with Kramer and one with Visage. You were on tonight. Unbelievable. You made some tremendous throws.
Mm-hmm. That comes from like working hard every single day, working on those kind of throws every single day. It's all about hard work. I mean, I even missed some that I should have made. I mean, that's what you got to say to yourself. It always can get better.
It's true. Now you got one more game to play.
Absolutely.
One more game to play.
Now we have one more stat.
Okay.
Now this I may be wrong.
Okay.
Your total passing yardage today, 1,982 yards, 24 TDs. And your rushing, not too bad, 1,901 yard rushing. So between the two, as we put together, that's 38-83 total offense.
You've had a pretty good year, good year.
Do you think you should be player of the week coming up?
That's not my business.
Rephrase that. Okay. I can say that.
All right.
If you don't become player of the week, there is something wrong in the voting system. And you can blame them because John Francola has been, for 30-some years, watching football.
Mm-hmm.
You have been one outstanding in this game. And this is probably not your best game. There's other games you were comparable.
Mm-hmm.
And you should be the player of the week.
Okay. You have been, what we saw as consistent. Okay. You've been consistent. So congratulations.
You
got one more mountain to climb, and
we'll be there.
We can't televise it, but we'll be there for it. Okay?
Quarter by quarter. Okay. Right. We'll see.
We'll talk to you.
Good luck and stay.
Best of you. Best of luck, Sean. Best of luck.
How about interviewing the Touchdown Club president?
Oh, we want to interview him.
If it wasn't for me, you wouldn't have the coffee and the donuts and the bagels.
We mentioned you. We thanked you.
The stats? Did you get the 6 games?
The stats? Yes, we got all that. Thank you very much. Former.
Give me that stat till it was in the bag.
So, again, we want to thank everybody. We're leaving here. The crowd is leaving. Outstanding game for Westwood. They move on. They play Marwa. It started here back in September. I think it was September 11th. Marwa came in, played Westwood. Now they're going to play him again, December 3rd, 4th. So, the circle is completed. Let's see what the circle brings us.
Well, you know, looking at the team that played that game where Marwa was ahead of them, they had a The line played well, De Palma, the quarterback, but this team has much improved, and the way Hopkins has improved with those two big guys, 6'3 and 6'5, you got Kramer, and I always get these two guys, and McKay. What a job, Larry.
Yeah, both teams have evolved in the last 8 or 9 weeks. So, again, for everybody, we want to thank you. It's been a pleasure to be here and be at the schools covering high school football. We have the best seat in the house. We enjoyed it. We will be having shows on WCTV, Exit 168, in December. Look at our website. And we're getting ready for basketball. The Jamboree will start. You'll see it on our website. We will be covering Jamboree wall-to-wall basketball. We're not finished with football. We're talking about what we're going to be doing. Just give you an idea of where we're going to be. So for the entire gang who covered all these games at WCTV throughout Northern New Jersey, I want to say thank you. Again, the final score as Westwood moves on to the finals. Westwood 42, High Point nothing. Good night, everybody.